Well, let's get into it. Let's talk about what you kind of teased at the beginning when it comes to homes on land specifically and what people are doing and thinking about, and with kind of everything that's going on around us right now, just all the insanity and craziness. You know, are people still moving out to, you know, moving further away with the land? Like, what's the thought process there for folks? What do people need to be thinking about?
Yeah, the answer, the shortest answer to all of that is yes. Now, when we say homes on land, what we mean is gigantic backyard, right? So we're not talking about a fully functioning farm or ranch. We can help you buy or sell a fully functioning farm or ranch, but honestly, that's not one of our core expertise. Homes on 2, 5, 8, 10 acres, that is one of our areas of a very specific specialization, right? So of course we're selling, you know, Dallas and Fort Worth, 300 and up neighborhoods all day, every day. All of our agents on our team are highly skilled at that, right? Like, that's the baseline foundational principle of our business, foundational property type of our business. But the specialization that a big chunk of our team really loves to work on and help clients on is a house with a 1 acre backyard, or a house on 2, 5, 6, 8, 10 acres, right? And those are absolutely still carrying a lot of momentum. I think this is probably a generational shift in our local marketplace, where I don't know the exact percentage quite yet, but a reasonable chunk of the market that is now able to work virtually, work from home, work self-employed from home, are saying, look, I've been paying, you know, I paid $400,000 for a nice 3-bed, 2-bath house in town, but I really would like a 4-bedroom, 3-bath house with a 3-car garage and some room for my kids to play, or to put in a pool, or to put a little gym in the house, or to store all my stuff at home instead of having a storage unit, right? I'd like to consolidate all that down to home, to one place. That is very much happening. We're seeing it happen in Benbrook. We're seeing it happen in Aledo. We're seeing it happen parts of Keller, South Lake. We're definitely seeing it in Wiley, Saxey, Murphy, Levon, Nevada, Parker. Lots of activity in Lucas. We've been out in Lucas a lot lately. Really, really love it. Several of our team members live in the area and are really, really thrilled at the growth of the Lovejoy School District, the Lucas area, the kind of the edge, northwest edge of Lake Levon, and getting out into the peninsula and some of the new construction that's happening over there. There's a lot of excitement in and around homes on land. So the shortest answer to your question is yes, that trend continues. If anything, it's continuing to build. It's continuing to grow. The momentum of that market segment is very, very strong. I know for a fact, to answer another part of your question, then I'll kick it back to you to make sure I'm answering it fully. A lot of folks I know went virtual, but then had gotten called back into the office. And they had kind of been waiting to see how things were going to go before they made a move further out. And they got called back to the office, and then within a week or two, they got sent back home. And a lot of them are under the impression, I know it's kind of, there's a lot of uncertainty in the media right now, but a lot of people are under the impression that this is kind of the last deal, that these companies that weren't sure, that didn't already go to a flex schedule, will now. They're not going to fight this fight anymore. They'll say, hey, you come into the office 1 day a week or 2 days a week for those key meetings or whatever. So I think that trend is about to pick up even more momentum.